A bright red cardinal returned from the deep south to tell Petey,
"Well, I do declare, we looked through every mountain range and along every river. We looked in the steamboats and at all the barbecues, but he just wasn't there."
"He weren't in the southwest neither," said the mockingbird.
"I checked every darn ranch and every last rodeo. No sign of him."
An eastern bluebird pecked Petey on the shoulder and said, "Hey, how you doing?"
"So check it out. We looked all up and down the eastern seaboard. Jersey, Manhattan, Long Island, you name it, we checked it.
Combed every beach and every boardwalk. We even looked up in the Statue of Liberty's crowd. Couldn't find you, Bobby."
"My name is Ben and I'm the writer for the Bird Network. It's an idea that my friend Jared came up with for his new baby girl, Aria."
After an hour passed, Petey got worried. Soon enough, though, many birds began to arrive from across the Atlantic Ocean.
Hi, I'm Audrienne, and I started this project because when I was little, I was very lucky. I had a father who was from England and a mother who was from all over the place, and I was living in North Carolina, and so I was able to actually imitate all these different dialects.
An Irish albatross was the first to report to Petey. "We thought he might be out pecking clover. Or perhaps playing with the sheep, or maybe even down the pub. But that Bobby, he couldn't be bothered to be found."
"Right. My name is Jared, and I'm Aria's dad. So my idea was we create a book and a CD that makes it so that a child can get exposed to and will be interested in the sounds and the inflections, because they're absorbing everything around them, the sounds and inflections of this book. But that same book can last till they're 3 or 4 because the story's so interesting. So that was our purpose here, and that's what we're doing."
"For me, this project is very personal. When I was young, I felt very disoriented in the world. I didn't know, you know, enough about the people in the world around me, from other cultures, other, you know, civilizations, even other languages at all. You know, I didn't know countries and landmarks around the world and what these people sounded like and how they lived. And with this project, you get a taste of so many places around the world."
A barn owl from Scotland was close behind. "We looked over the highlands, the islands, among the wild heather, and along the sea cliffs, and even at the golf tournaments."
"But we didn't say, Bobby."
"Well, when we actually heard the story, and when I read it out loud for the first time, we said to ourselves, okay, this we need to share. It's too good to keep to ourselves. This is the kind of thing that other parents are going to want to hear, and they're going to want to read to their kids. And they're going to want their kids to have a recording so that they can listen along and talk along with the recording."
Petey turned to a cockerel that had just flown in from France.
"Did you find Bobby?"
"Malheureusement, non. We scoured the banks of the Seine, looked all up and down the Tour Eiffel, in every café and along the Riviera. I'm afraid that your baby, he was not to be found."
"I also have a friend named Danny who is our artist. He's fantastic. Here's some of his work."
Next to arrive was an Italian pelican who flapped his wings dramatically as he spoke, causing the other birds to hop backwards a bit.
"Mamma mia, we went to the Colosseo, searched the Leaning Tower of Pisa, and all through the vineyards. But he wasn't nowhere we could have found him, huh?"
3 English birds arrived just then, a raven, a pigeon, and a partridge. The raven said,
"Bobby is not in the Tower of London, Buckingham Palace, or any of our other castles. We even did a thorough search through the forest in a thick fog, but I'm afraid he eluded us."
The way the maps tie into this, and the way the maps tie into this, and the reason why that's important is because it orients you to your world, right? It shows you, like, where people are of different races and different cultures, and it shows you what is real to them, like what landmarks are around them and what how they might live and what it might look like there. And also you can see, you know, where you are in relation to them.
The raven looked like she would continue, but the pigeon interrupted.
"Oi, Percy Pigeon, eh? Breaks me blooming heart to tell you this, Petey, old pal, but we checked the tubes. Piccadilly Circus, Big Ben, even took a gander in old Westminster Abbey. I haven't seen eye nor hour of him."
The partridge piped in.
"That's right. Same with us up in the north. We saw a lamb and a goat up on the moor who both answered to the name of Bobby. But they weren't the right one, were they?"
What do you think, Aria? Do you think Petey will find Bobby? Obviously, she doesn't understand what we're saying. But the cool thing is that she is actually absorbing all of the subtle inflections, far more of the dialects than we can understand. And what's cool about this, what makes me really excited about this book, is that it's good for young kids because of that, and it's good for older kids because they will actually understand the story, and it's a really cool story.